horse back in the wild again. And I feel right at home where I belong.
Well, hey there, little fella. What are you doing?
Go on now. Get.
You hear that stream over there? You think there could be elk? Oh, yeah.
We're scouting for elk.
Looking at that, we didn't know what it was, trying to figure it out, but you got mountain lions out here, so we're thinking maybe one of those big cats coughed up a big hairball.
Causes the elk to want to move around to different spots and stuff. it's a squirrel. There's a squirrel. It's been following us around. If you look right there, it looks like another hairball. Sometimes we'll be, you know, we're hiking up. I feel like I can hear something. I sense it. Something's engaging or tracking us. I can sometimes hear. Like, I'm going to turn around and there's going to be a mountain lion or a wolf, maybe. Grizzly bear spray. I think if it was a grizzly bear following us, you'd for sure hear it. This is better than even using a gun, they say, because you got to obviously hit the bear in the right spot if you were to shoot it. But even that bullet might not stop it. This usually helps. That's the thing, you walk out of the woods, but think of it all in the openness. Mark, what are you checking?
I made a trail. See it now.
On Hunnox.
Got it.
Big footprints. If I'm stuck here at night, I can find it easy.
Cool. I'm gonna walk up over there, scout the area. Let's go check it out. It's a big elk footprint. Strong little roots. Be strong.
An old cowboy was riding out one dark and windy day. Up on a ridge he rested as he went along.
Trail mix?
No, good things. Our base camp is literally 1,000 yards that way.
Base camp?
Our base camp. Shit. But with the hill and the terrain,
yeah,
it's 3 miles of walking to here to there. It shows you the difference.
Oh, really?
So if you're like, you can't really just pin an arrow and walk because you're going down some steep inclines.
Yeah. 3 miles back to base camp?
Yeah. That's not bad.
We hiked all the way down.
Yeah.
I swear that squirrel, I think it's the same one following us around.
They've been following you since camp. Through the woods. It's been following you.
Yeah.
Wants to go home with you.
Look at that view. If you look, got some snow up there on top of the mountain.
Potatoes.
Woo! You don't get better than that, man.
I'm gonna break my rusty cage and run. Burns along the road.
Found some gold. Man?
Found gold?
Take a look. See the specs? That's gold specs.
Where?
I'm telling you, it's gold.
Where's the where the head. Gold specs?
Yeah, right there.
Like that
leprechaun
says there's
gold up in that. There's gold up here in these mountains.
Show me the gold. Where's the gold at?
The gold.
That's it. You keep it? You gonna take it?
Yeah, you take it. That's a souvenir for you.
Get that shit out of here.
Nothing nowadays.
Take it as a souvenir for you. Hey.
A lot of deer and elk to head towards the thick timber to stay warm, get out of that wind. This is why we're not going to deep timber. Just do a little spot and stock. We'll see what happens. Rock check in. We are currently over by the clearing. Just west of the Eagle's Nest, about 600 yards.
Too cold to start a fire, I'm burning diesel, burning dinosaur bone. I'll take the river down the still water and ride a pack of dogs.
Sit here, you're sitting up in a tree stand, and you just sit all day.
We already walked.
about line tracks.
Nice job.
Thanks.
Heat. I'm walking up the trail. I pass the middle trail where all the blowdowns are.
Yep.
And I was just gonna walk my way back. And then I come across this.
Fresh tracks.
Sometime
this afternoon.
Yeah. Something so, kicked it up.
So it was near. You know where we heard that elk bugle and chuckle?
Yeah.
It was right near there.
That area, yes. So yeah. You just go there in the morning then.
So I start following that. I thought it was going down towards that area.
Mm-hmm.
Because it looked like there was a little bit of snow on top of it.
Yeah.
But then I realized I was going the wrong way.
Oh.
So I maybe went like 100 yards.
Turn around, okay.
And I turned around. And then I started tracking it the other way.
Yeah.
When it came to this.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, bedded for a
bedded life. Down.
Let's see.
Oh, there's three of them.
No, it's just one.
Oh, just one. That's a big one. Look at that big bed.
You could smell them. I'm 90% sure.
This thing is a bull?
It's a bull.
Yeah, no, it's coming single, see. That's why. Only bulls will be alone.
Yeah. And you could smell it. So then I just started following him, and then he's kind of in that middle area between where the blowdown is and the truck, just weaving around on that ridge.
Yep.
And then he crosses that trail again where the blowdowns are. He comes up to my tracks.
Are you serious?
Going up Rock Ridge Circle.
No shit. That's awesome.
As soon as it sees my tracks, it turns and goes to the right.
Really?
Yep. It would not cross my tracks.
So your scent was still there or something. Yeah. Interesting.
So then I followed that. He's found my trail. Back. Went back to the ridge.
Yeah.
And then I was fresh enough that I could see he went down the steep embankment.
Yep.
And I could still see dirt.
Yeah.
That was kicked up.
You were right on his ass.
I was close.
Yeah.
But I'm like, I was not going to go down that big ravine.
No, you can't get back up.
I was 90% sure it was a bull anyways.
Oh, yeah.
And, yeah.
Damn it.
It was close.
That would have been cool to see.
I wish I would have just at least seen it.
Yeah.
How big it was, but.
That's awesome.
Yeah. That was the freshest sign I've
seen. Well, that's not a good story.
It's a great story.
There you go.